So the initial concept for this entire thing was that I was going to disprove the RC cars that you see on YouTube, TikTok, whatever, going to buy things, you know? And the implication with those is that somebody's like at their house with the car and the goggles and they're just driving to the store and buying stuff.
All right, we're gonna drive this RC car to the store to buy some chocolate.
I'm working on this video where, you know, the RC car guys that drive like 4,000 miles to pick up a candy bar from Walmart, right?
They go buy Mr. Beast bars from Walmart.
Yeah.
I talked about this video on a podcast several weeks ago, and there were people in the comments saying, oh, all those cars that are doing that stuff, they're using 4G.
This camera on the front is how I'll see everything, and in this headset will be how I look, see where I'm going.
So I think that some people may have been talking about other videos where there are 4G cars. I don't know what they're talking about because the videos that I've seen, they have FPV antennas on the car. Or the one specific video that I showed, he has goggles with two antennas. That's 5.8, that's FPV. Yeah, so overall, I think a really interesting lesson in all of this is that don't believe everything you see online. And I think that we see a lot of videos and we see a lot of stuff on TikTok, YouTube Shorts, Instagram, whatever, you know? And I think at a certain point, people just start assuming that, oh, everything that's presented in these videos is actually factually happening. And that's really, really the most unfortunate thing about all of this. And I think that's the greater message here is that just assume everything that you see, every video is fake. That's how I like live my life, you know? I just assume everything's fake until otherwise proven true. You can't even trust this YouTube video. Yeah, so ultimately, I don't really care too much about trying to disprove these other channels or videos or whatever. It's not really that important to me. It doesn't really matter. But just so you know, it's fake. They're probably in the parking lot doing this or something and just making you think that they're at their house. But I did an analog setup where I drove an analog car just across the field and it got pretty far. You know, I was surprised at how far it went, but there was nothing in its way. There was one point though where I did go down a little hill, like a little behind a fence area, and it was a little shaky. So I can only imagine if I actually drove behind a building. I don't really care to like test all that because it doesn't matter. What I did do is I put a DJI O3 Air unit on the car, which in my opinion is probably the best video system for range and penetration. Analog is not gonna do nearly as well as the O3 unit regardless, right? I could run tests and be like, oh, analog did this, analog did that. But as soon as it goes behind a building, analog, you're gonna lose video. But the O3 is gonna have a better penetration because of how the system works. And I'm not gonna explain that, you can just look it up. That's sort of where we're at, you know? I'm gonna test this out, see how this does. You know what I gave? I don't want to fuck with that anymore. I don't want to do the, you know, broadcast video systems or anything like that because I just spent $30 on a SIM card and I got the SIM hat for this Raspberry Pi here. Yesterday, I spent several hours trying to configure this Raspberry Pi to basically just connect to the internet with the SIM card. That's it. And I want to shout out to Lucky Luciano from the Bot Grinder Discord for sitting with me in the voice chat and helping me debug and figure this out because networking shit, I don't know shit about that. What's 502 bad gateway?
That's server error. What?
Yeah, so that's the IP address from the Pi. From the Pi though, let me try from my Mac and see what happens.
3 hours later.
Now, here's the one thing. I would have had this done way sooner, but I kept getting distracted by the fixed wing airplane.
Oh, that was good. Oh my God.
Did you get that?
Yeah, all right, where are you? Where are you?
You're right now.
Scott. Oh, God damn, right when I found you.
Now, one thing I want to do with the Sony PlayStation controller is I want to try to get it to actually control the thing. So I think it's gonna be the easiest way to do it. Watch out, move, move. Fucking works. It's finicky though. Very finicky. I just gotta do a little bit of a do coating, you know. All right. So I have some very, very pleasant news right now. So I found out last night when I was trying to configure this thing or drive it around, it was like really finicky on the control sticks. And I thought, oh, well, this is just really small little PS4 controller. So like there's not enough movement or not enough, you know, throw in the sticks. So it's not gonna work. But what I did is I realized that on these ESCs, they have this programmer. Which is, by the way, a fucking scam, okay? Either way, the ESC was on forward, brake, reverse. So the brake was causing issues because it didn't, I don't think that the PWM signal knew, I don't know, I'm not a magician. Right now, it's driving over Wi-Fi, so I still need to turn the 4G on, but I know that's gonna work. You know, you never know though. Currently it's day, I don't know how many days I've been doing, going at this. It's connected through 4G. There's like really bad latency. So hopefully when I get it outside, there won't be a problem. Now, the past couple of days, I spent trying to get everything to start up on boot. And for some reason, I couldn't get the 4G network to connect when I booted the Pi. But then I realized that I didn't do some Magic Linux stuff. So I did some Magic Linux stuff. And now everything works. Now I'm fighting with latency, which is just the nature of the game. Controller started, go backward. We're going backward. All right, let's go forward. Let's turn. Oh, it's turning the wrong direction. Okay, so we need to fix that. Here we go, backward. Dude, that's pretty bad. Yeah, so that latency is definitely a big issue. I don't know if I can fix that. I don't know. I just probably maybe have to do something different with the input. Everything with this, the latency has been fixed. Now there still is a little bit of latency, but that's just the nature of it. So like, and then we'll see everything as it happens. That's a success, I would say. And it's all over 4G right now in my house, which is gets pretty bad service regardless with my phone. So that's pretty decent over the network. So I'm pretty stoked about this right now. This video is brought to you by E6000 and all the great things that it can do. I just E6000 the Raspberry Pi to the case so that it doesn't come out. Probably E6000 this antenna mount as well. Okay, we're ready, finally. Wait for this car to leave though, there's a car here. Here we go. Well, it looks like it crashed, so I have to, you know, go recover this thing. You know, the latency, right? The latency will, you know, sometimes sneak up on you and you just aren't expecting it. I realized it may be visible in the video of me driving through the neighborhood that I ended up using this radio controller. This thing, if you plug it in with USB, it can be a USB game controller. And I didn't really drive that far, but I did drive about 3 or 4 blocks roughly. So it's definitely gonna go infinitely. We just know that. It's 4G, as long as there's data, you can just drive it. So I could put this thing anywhere, drive it from anywhere, and that's just how it is.